gonna start to build my heavy duty 96 volt 200 amps continuous battery pack. I'm gonna use these 18650s. They are original, bought on AliExpress. These are 300 milliamps and they are 6.5C, so they can continuously charge around 20 amps. I'm gonna build a pack consisting of 24S14P. That means continues to charge about 280 amps. And these can also discharge, I think it was 98 amps in short bursts, but I'm not gonna use it. And these are original LG Chem, sort of. my first plan was to build the pack with these cheap plastic pieces you can buy on internet and join it all together with these thin nickel strips. But if you calculate on the area, you soon realize that these will not handle the 400 amps bursts, and it won't work. So after some googling around, I found these other system. Also on AliExpress from a Chinese supplier, and you join the batteries with these plastic pieces, red and black, so you can separate plus and minus easily, and you join together with these pre-made nickel plates. They are all 0.02 millimeter in thickness, and you tack spot weld them like this, and then you build your pack, and each cell you then connect with these copper plates, and the area that connect these cells together are 18 square millimeters, and with copper and 18 square millimeters you can handle the power of 400 amps. It will get hot, but it will work. Yes, let's start.
Well, now I've started to fit these plates. They are pre-made and bolted in place, so I easily can have the spot welding in the right position. Okay, now I'm preparing the wiring for the BMS. I use these connectors, but I also soldered the joints because I wanted the good contact, and they're going to be in an enclosure, so it's kind of hard to know if things are working, so I'm just doing two of these to be fail safe.
Finally, I managed to spot weld all the nickel plates. I used 0.02 millimeter thick nickel plates to so I can handle the 400 amp, and as I said before, this is a 24S14P setup, 96 volts, and the battery is approximately nominal. It's I think it was continuous discharge, it's 20 amps each, so it's continuous to 208 amps as in my engine, so it's going to work quite well.
This is the battery box I was talking about. This one fits the cross cart, and it's also going to fit the snow cross.
So I can use this in the winter and that one in the summer. That's the idea. Well, now I put some isolation so it won't get shortcuts, and I use this Kaplan tape and this green isolation. And now I'm gonna put these modules together. Oops. Well, I'm
wiring this packs together with this 6 square millimeters wiring. Well, now it's all connected. Now I'm gonna measure and see what kind of voltage we have. Like that.
Well, I'm trying to fit all the electrical stuff into the box. I must connect the discharge relay, and this is for the shunt and also the BMS system, and then I also have to find a way to connect it to the 12 volt system. Okay, I got it started, and I can see the voltage, and there are two cells a bit off, and I can see the state of charge, and I also got the starter charger running, and it's all set for 24S. Here you can see the different menus. There are two cells out of this setup. Well, quite pleased.